Revered Swami Atmeshwarananda Ji Maharaj was inspired by the ideologies of Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna and Swami Vivekananda. He joined the Ramakrishna Order of Monks in 1986. Since then, Swamiji has been at Belur Math. Currently, Swami Atmeshwarananda Ji Maharaj is the finance officer of RKMVERI, Ramakrishna Mission Headquarters. For 3 years, Swamiji was working in auditing department and continues his service in banking and investment department of Ramakrishna Mission and Math Belur. Now I respectfully call upon revered Swami Atmeshwarananda Ji Maharaj to deliver Dr. Avinashilingam 5th Memorial Lecture titled Swami Vivekananda's Educational Vision.
Namah Shri Atirajaya Vivekananda Suray Satchit Sukha Swarupaya Swamine Tapaharine. Revered Swami Gautamananda Ji Maharaj, Revered Atma Priyananda Ji Maharaj, the two other Swamis on the dais, my loving namaskars to both of you, Revered Gyanapurnananda Ji Maharaj in the audience, my pranams to you, loving namaskars to all the assembled monks and brahmacharins, namaskars and good wishes, Dr. Chandra Bhusan Sharma, Chairman of National Institute of Open Schooling, assembled teaching, non-teaching staff, volunteers, students, guardians, namaskars, good wishes to all of you. I have been trying to participate in this Coimbatore wing, part of the convocation of the VERI Institute for the last 2 or 3 years. We conduct the convocation in Belur Math on the 4th of July every year, and I've had the privilege of being the MC for the last 3 years, twice at Narendrapur and once this year at Belur Math. Somehow, this Coimbatore link was not being properly connected. This year, Swami Atmeshwarananda Ji insisted rather that I should go with him, and so here I am. Thank you all for giving me a chance to be with you on this happy occasion, the 13th convocation, to deliver what has been called the 5th Memorial Lecture, the Avinashilingam Memorial Lecture. The topic given is Swamiji's Educational Vision, or Swamiji's Thoughts on Education. Now, Swami Vivekananda was perhaps the first person to present a vision, a picture of a glowing new India. And he was convinced that this could be made possible through the right kind of education. As we just heard many times, he wanted a man-making education, an education rooted in our ancient country's spiritual culture. He wanted scientific reason yoked to Vedantic faith, the past linked to the future through the present. As most of us know, Swamiji discussed these unique ideas with Jamshedji N. Tata, when they voyaged together from Japan to America in 1893. Incidentally, it was this introduction with Swami Vivekananda that inspired J.N. Tata to start the now famous Indian Institute of Science at Bengaluru. Before we take up Swamiji's educational ideas, we will take a look at his ideal, at what he says about his ideal in his own words, and then see how his thoughts on education go towards fulfilling this. In a letter written in June 1896 to Miss Margaret Noble, the future sister Nivedita, Swamiji writes, "My ideal indeed can be put into a few words, and that is to preach unto mankind their divinity and how to manifest it in every movement of life." And having stated his ideal, Swamiji states what the aim of education should be. We want that education by which strength of character is increased, character is formed, strength of character is increased, the intellect is expanded, and by which one can stand on one's own feet. What we want is Western science coupled with Vedanta, Brahmacharya as the guiding force, and also Shraddha and faith in oneself. Now, Indian tradition has always recognized two streams of categories of knowledge or studies, Vidya and Avidya, Paravidya and Aparavidya, Pratyak Prakriti and Parak Prakriti, Kshetra and Kshetradnya. These could simply be translated as science of the outer world and of the inner, sensory knowledge and supersensory knowledge, knowledge of the Kshetra, the outside universe, and of the Kshetradnya, knowledge of the knower of the universe. Of course, it's a different matter. But ultimately, it is asked, how can the knower be known? Vidnyataramare kena vijaniyat. Without going into much details, we will take up Swamiji's most quoted statement. Education is the manifestation of the perfection already in man. And this cannot be accomplished only by academic studies. A story in our Chandogya Upanishad amply illustrates this. Sage Narada was vastly learned. He went to Sage Sharanta Kumara for further illumination. For with all his learning and erudition, Narada was not free from misery. Sanat Kumar asks him to let him know what all he's already studied so that he can guide him accordingly. So Narada gives him a complete list of what all that he has mastered: the four Vedas, the Vedangas or auxiliary Vedas, the Puranas, Itihasas, grammar, science of pronunciation. Then we have astrology, science of warfare, dancing, singing, logic, ethics, etymology, sarpavidya, science of serpents, playing on musical instruments, and the list goes on. As we can see, this is a very impressive list, to say the least. But in today's world, this list would have fetched Narada multiple PhDs. And now, Narada makes an astonishing statement to Sanat Kumara, bringing out the glory, the significance of India's Paravidya, supersensory knowledge. He says, "Sir, I am only a master of words. I have not known the Atman, the basis of all knowledge. I have heard from great men like you that one who knows the Atman goes beyond sorrow. Please instruct me about the Atman. Soham Bhagavo Mantravid Eva Asmi Na Atmavid Shrutammi Eva Me Bhagavad Drishebhya Tarati Shokham Atmavid Iti." This shows that collecting a lot of information does not make us educated. As Swamiji says, education is not mere book learning, but the training by which the will is brought under control and used rightly is education. Please mark those words. The training by which the will is brought under control and used rightly is education. Let us go to another aspect now. The Maharaja of Khetri, Ajit Singh, who was Swamiji's devoted disciple, had once asked him, "What is education?" And Swamiji had replied, "Education is a nervous association of certain ideas." And Swamiji went on to clarify that unless ideas become instincts, they would not be of much help to a character and consciousness. Swamiji found living proof of this in his guru, Sri Ramakrishna. Whatever idea was dear to Sri Ramakrishna's heart would go deep into his consciousness, and would be not separable from him. He could no longer distinguish from that idea. It was not that a person called Sri Ramakrishna absorbed and assimilated certain virtues like truth, purity, non-possession, looking upon all women as one's own mother, etc. These ideas became part and parcel of his nervous system and made the person himself the idea. We can look at just a single example incident in Sri Ramakrishna's life to understand this. The idea that he shall not possess money, that he shall not touch money, had possessed him and became embedded in his nervous system. To test him, Naren, as Vivekananda was known earlier, inserted a coin under his bed. When Sri Ramakrishna came unknowingly and sat on the cot a little later, his whole system, his own body, reacted unconsciously to throw him off the cot as if he was stung by a deadly scorpion. How to assimilate? This assimilation comes to us, this capacity for assimilation comes to us from self-discipline and self-discipline alone. Our nation needs today to generate within itself this capacity to assimilate lofty values and ideals. We have had the historically developed capacity to grasp and keep ideas, but for want of willpower and humanistic urge, they have remained mostly in our heads, static and sterile. They have failed to percolate to the heart and nervous system, into our bones and muscles. So we need this sort of experience today, this nervous association of ideas, to be able to enjoy the fruits of the Vedantic personality, which is clear vision, broad sympathies, and intense practicality. This would then enable getting the four purusharthas in life, dharma, artha, kama, and moksha, as has been traditionally taught in our country. Here Swamiji warns us. Before that, we heard about personal development from Swami Gautamanandji Maharaj. In fact, we hear a lot about today about personality development. According to Swamiji, that personality is fully developed in whom there is a harmonious combination or synthesis of the four faculties that each one of us possesses, the faculties of thinking, feeling, willing, and doing. A fully developed brain, a sympathetic and feeling heart, dexterity in work. When these three are integrated through the power of concentration or meditation, one achieves a fully developed personality. This then should be the scope of the education that we get. Swamiji here warns us, education is not the amount of information that is put into your brain undigested and runs right there undigested all your life. We must have life building, man making, character making assimilation of ideas. Our education system today gives a citizen or a student the weight of knowledge in the head, but knows very little about its value. We study history, but our behavior does not express the lessons or values we learn from history. History teaches us that for lack of national unity, for lack of broad ideas, in the absence of social justice, our country has lost its freedom time and again. Yet, we behave in public and in private in ways which jeopardize our national unity and freedom, one after intense decades of intense struggle. The same situation obtains in other fields of study, like law or logic, science or civics, philosophy or religion. To study law and behave lawlessly, to study civics and be indifferent to social sense, to study the sciences and be indifferent to scientific outlook makes a mockery of education. Such education does not impart dynamism to ideas. It does not result in force of character. It does not result in a fruitful character. And it does not thwarts efficiency in life and action. Just like physical efficiency and physical strength are the product of well-digested and assimilated food, so also well-assimilated and digested ideas produce rich and complete personalities. undigested food becomes a poison and an enemy of the body. Similarly, undigested knowledge, undigested ideas become a poison and an enemy of the mind. Vanity, a superiority complex, the tendency to outsmart, and similar many negative mental traits are the poisonous fruit of undigested knowledge. To summarize then what we have just talked about, we have talked about the scope of academic studies, the nervous association of ideas leading to their assimilation, and the four harmonizing our four faculties. To these, when these are combined together, we get a real character, a man with real character. It seems that Swamiji summarizes his thoughts on education by giving them a logical conclusion. He says, can one ask for more? A verse in the Katha Parishad tells us what happens to one who realizes the Atman. Etadeva aksharam jnatva yo yadichhasi tasya tat. And Swamiji gives us this wonderful translation of this mantra. He says, this infinite spirit, this infinite strength of the spirit, power of the spirit, brought to bear upon matter, evolves for material development. Made to bear upon thought, evolves intellectually. And made to act upon itself, makes of man a god. Can one ask for more? Just one small word of caution and brotherly advice to our students today who are passing out. உலகத்தில் எந்த மூலையாக போனால் கூட சுவாமிஜியை மறக்காதுங்க. இத்தனை பண்ணிங்களா ஆனந்தமாக இருக்கலாம். எங்கள் சதுவுகளை பாருங்க, ராமகிட்ட மட்டும் சதுவுகளெல்லாம் பாருங்க, ஆனந்தமாக இருக்கும். ஏன் சுவாமிஜி எனக்கு ஆதர்ஷனும் வச்சுருக்கோம், ஒப்புக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம். நம்ம சசி மகாராஜன் தெரியுமா அவங்களுக்கு, இவர்த்தி சொன்னார் ஆத்மபிரியானந்தஜி, சுவாமி ராமகிருஷ்ணானந்தஜி, அவர் சுவாமிஜி மேலே ஒரு சின்ன ஸ்தோத்திரம் எழுதியிருக்கார். அதில் ஒரு லைன் வருது, சன்ஸ்கிருத்தில் எழுதியிருக்க ஸ்லோகம், அது ஒரு லைன் வருது, ஆனந்தமூர்த்தி தமஹம் நமாமி, ஆனந்தமூர்த்தியும் தமஹம் நமாமி என்றார். இவர் வந்து ஆனந்தமூர்த்தி சுவாமிஜி. அவர் பிடிச்சுட்டு இருங்கோ, உலகத்தில் உங்களுக்கு என்னமே யாருமே ஒன்றும் பண்ண முடியாது. ஓம் சாந்தி சாந்தி சாந்தி, ஹரி ஓம் தத்சத்.